Taking in one of the world's natural wonders.
We want to see people from around the world and across Australia taking this in for generations and generations well into the future. This is our stewardship.
But this crown jewel of the ocean is under increasing threat from global warming. So much so, the United Nations is considering listing the World Heritage Site as in danger.
We know that climate change is the biggest threat to the reef, and we're playing our part internationally.
Last year, Australia successfully delayed a decision, but the government is due to report back to UNESCO by next month. Against that backdrop, announcing a major boost, $1 billion to help protect the Great Barrier Reef spent over the next decade. The bulk will go towards reducing nutrient and pesticide runoff, more than $250 million for reef management and conservation, like controlling threats from the crown of thorns starfish. Funds also set aside for resilience and adaptation strategies, as well as community projects for traditional owners.
It's a step up in terms of the rate of funding that's going out to all of these actions from the $2 billion that's already invested.
While the spending has been welcomed, experts say the government is not doing nearly enough to address the root cause.
One can be very cynical about the timing of this announcement, but regardless of whether it's this month or next month or last year, the money really isn't being targeted at the major threat to the reef, which is climate change.
It's not just the timing of this funding in regards to that UNESCO deadline that is being questioned, but the looming federal election too. The Great Barrier Reef generates billions of dollars a year in tourism, with 64,000 jobs also dependent on its health.
It shouldn't take 5 minutes to midnight, election campaign and UNESCO report to get this government to act on the reef.
Prime Minister with yet another pre-election bribe on the reef. This is the same government that has been boosting for the coal and gas sector.
This project has been many, many months in the making.
And just months away from when voters get to have their say. Pablo Viñales, SBS World News.